music fans. Today we have another fun episode of Bedford Backstage for you. With me today is superstar Natalie Lewis.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Thanks for coming in.
Thanks for having me. Thank you.
So nice that you're here. Now, you're probably looking at Natalie and saying, wait a second, I know that young lady. And that's because you remember her from playing Fairy Godmother in the most recent Bedford High School musical, Cinderella.
Yep.
Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella, right?
Yes, not the classic. Yeah.
Yes. How was that?
It was exciting. That was that was one of my first like important lead roles. So I was really? So excited.
You would never so know. Excited. You were so impressive. Afterwards, everyone was just saying, oh, Fairy Godmother stole the show. And so I was so excited to come see. You did such an amazing
Thank
job.
Thank you. Thank you.
Do you love inhabiting roles like that are just so bigger than life?
I do. I do. I feel like that was probably, again, like that was one of my biggest roles.
Yeah.
So it was kind of a challenge, but I really, really loved it. I loved it.
Wow. And how was the rest of the cast? A lot of good
amazing
friends.
Apparently, yeah. Apparently, that was one of the biggest cast days they've ever had.
Oh,
so
I did not know that.
I loved it. Loved it.
That's great. And you did not see Natalie in last year's musical because Natalie is new to Bedford. You just moved up here from
Maryland.
From Maryland, mm-hmm. Just a year ago. So Natalie is a new talent to Bedford.
Brand new.
Brand new. And we're thrilled you're here. So back in Maryland, what musicals did you do there?
So one of my first musicals was Seussical, where I played the Sour Kangaroo, and that was exciting. And then I did Schoolhouse Rock Live, and I sang Conjunction Junction. I don't know if you might remember that. my next show, it was in the Heights.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. And then after that, I think it was in Cinderella after In the Heights.
Excellent. And which of those musicals was your favorite from the ones you did in Maryland?
Well, In the Heights was my favorite one from Maryland, definitely.
Yeah. What did you like about it?
I like that it was not like your classic musical.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like a hip-hop R&B type musical, so that was exciting. Oh. Yeah, and we did a lot of hip-hop dancing and things like that, and so I really like that.
You do not see hip-hop dancing in musicals.
Not a lot. I guess recently you might, you know, with Hamilton and everything, but...
Yes, and you taught me. I learned something new with every Bedford Backstage episode about the person who wrote In the Heights and Hamilton.
Mm-hmm. That was Lin-Manuel Miranda. He did both. Yeah.
So now you know. So if you want to see Hamilton but don't have $3,000 kicking around,
exactly,
go see In the Heights. It'll be a nice warm-up.
Yeah.
Someday maybe we'll see you in Hamilton. How fun would that be?
That would be... The role of a lifetime.
Yeah. When you heard it here first, Bedford Backstage. Mm. Someday Natalie Lewis will be
just
in
Hamilton.
Just
to be an ensemble member in Hamilton would be amazing.
Would be. That'd be great. They're touring. Not yet. Someday.
Yeah.
I should stop talking about this.
No, it's okay.
I don't know enough.
We could honestly do this entire show about Hamilton.
Just
and
about.
Have more to talk about.
Oh, all right. Good. So you sing in musicals, of course, mm-hmm. and then you're also part of some of the ensembles at Bedford High School.
Yes.
So tell us about those.
Along with like the normal chorus,
mm-hmm.
I do band. Okay. I do marching band. I play tenor saxophone in that.
Fun.
Yep. And then I'm part of their jazz band where I play tenor saxophone and I sing in that also.
Very cool.
Which is cool. And then I'm a part of the a cappella groups, the Bella Chords, which is the female a cappella group, mm-hmm. and the Rolling Tones, which is the new co-ed a cappella group.
That's great. I love that Bedford has a co-ed a cappella group.
I know. That's so nice.
That's so fun. Yeah. You guys did a fantastic job. I'm sure you saw the Vertical Chorus concert, Bella Chords, did that. And
yes.
Were Rolling Tones?
Mm-hmm. We were there, too. I don't remember what we sang.
I don't either. I didn't know you guys
did
were
sing.
New. How exciting.
Yeah.
That's so fun. And then jazz band, singing in the jazz band, that's like a totally different vibe.
That's so awesome. Yeah, I sang in the jazz band at my old school, so I was really happy to hear that he wanted a singer for this one, too. Yeah. So,
Is that new, that there's a singer? You came from Maryland, and Bedford High School just changed completely. We have singing in the jazz band, a co-ed a cappella group, Fairy Godmother that steals the show. It's amazing.
Yeah.
You have big shoes to fill now.
Just glad
you
to
made.
Be here.
And right now you're even in a musical, not at Bedford High School, as we know.
No.
That year has wound down. Where are you performing now?
I am in Hairspray at Mount Wachusett Community College. It's with a Theater at the Mount community group. So, yeah, I'm excited for that.
Very good. And who are you playing in Hairspray?
Oh, I'm playing a Dynamite, which is kind of like a Supreme group member. Like, there's three of us. And, yeah, we sing on one of the TV shows in the musical.
Oh, very fun.
Yeah.
That's great. You get really fun roles.
I know. I feel blessed.
And so you also have two younger sisters.
Two here. Younger sisters. Yep.
And your dad works in the Coast Guard.
Mm-hmm.
So you have got a lot going on.
A lot going on.
And when you graduate from Bedford High next year, what do you think you'll do?
I don't know where I'm going to go yet, but I do know that I have to do something with music. And while yes. I do want to do performance, of course, I have to try to think of something more practical, mm-hmm. as my parents would say. Mm-hmm. So probably music education, something like that, where I can kind of do both, have a job, perform, kind of something like that.
Right. Mm-hmm. Perform at your job.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Yeah. Could really have a job anywhere and just perform at it, though. Wouldn't that be fun?
That would be amazing. That's the dream.
I think you could pull it off. Like, you could be an accountant and just be singing.
Just saying. That'd be amazing.
Yeah, why not?
Exactly.
You change the world. And so you're going to sing for us. And tell us what you're
going
to sing.
I'm going to sing Rumor Has It by Adele.
Very fun.
Yes.
All right. We can't wait. We will now see Natalie Lewis sing Rumor Has It. With Natalie Lewis. Natalie, nice job.
Thank you.
It's brave to sing a song we all hear on the radio all the time. I certainly couldn't do it. But now our viewers may notice we did not discuss what voice lessons you take during our first segment. And that's because...
I don't take any.
No. Everybody should rewind their DVR or YouTube. You don't take any voice lessons and you can sing like that?
I mean, the only direction I've ever had is just like my family telling me if they like what I'm singing or not. And then like, obviously my music director is helping me, but I've never had like one-on-one lessons like that. No.
It doesn't seem possible to me because my family gives me feedback on how I sing, and I don't think that feedback would ever get me to where you are. That was really impressive.
Thank you. Thank you.
I loved it. You, I kind of put like your own spin on it too, a little bit.
Just a little bit. Yeah, I know how to change it up. Yeah.
A little flair.
Just a little bit.
So Paula Gilardi, our, what would we call her, our show producer? She has these 8 questions that we ask every guest.
Okay.
And so I'm going to ask you, are you ready?
I think so.
Okay. What, Natalie Lewis, is your favorite word?
Okay, my favorite word would have to be lit.
Okay, you're going to have to tell me what that means.
So if you say, so if something's lit, yes, that means that it's like it's really good or fun or exciting. So like this show is lit.
Your performance was lit.
Was lit? Thank you.
Yes. Excellent. All right. I don't know if I'm ready to use it in casual conversation. Okay. But I'll try.
Oh, you have to build up to it. I use it all the time now, but it took me a while.
Did it? Okay, yeah. That makes me feel better. And what is your least favorite word?
My least favorite word, this is probably a popular one, but moist.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's pretty disgusting.
I don't really like that word. I don't like thinking of moist things.
Humid, okay.
Humid's okay. Moist.
But moist. It's like, why do people even use the word?
I don't know.
Oh, they should know.
I don't know.
Ugh. Yeah. Moist is not lit.
Moist is not lit.
Can you say things moist are not lit, or am I now using the word incorrectly?
No, I would say things are not lit.
Good, okay.
I would say that.
Oh, that makes me feel better.
Okay.
What sound or noise do you love?
This might not even count as a sound or noise.
Oh, it counts.
But I like the sound of like other languages.
Oh.
So like people speaking in other languages is like one of my favorite things ever. And then I like when people... I love when people say my name in other languages or like their relationship of my, I love it. I like the way they sound, like accents.
Very clever response, now.
I know.
So even if you don't understand a word of what they're saying, just like listening to the cadence and the
love it, the like salsa music. I'm obsessed with it.
Oh,
because it's in another language and it's fun and like I don't know what they're saying, but I love the sound.
I need to know. And what sound or noise do you hate? Don't say the English language.
No, okay. No. I hate the sound of people chewing.
Oh, that kind of goes back to the moist thing.
I can't stand it. It makes me angry.
Yeah, so like gum chewers.
Gum chewers. And then it's honestly like all kinds of like little noises. Like I hate the sound of like calculators and like any type of clicking. I don't enjoy.
No clicking, no chewing.
I know. I'm okay if I chew. If I use my own calculator, but if someone else is using it near me and I can hear it, it's like.
What if they're like chewing and calculating? That's send you over the edge.
Yeah, like math class gets a little rough sometimes. I don't like to take tests because all I hear is just the clicking.
Oh my gosh. Wow, it's bad. Need earplugs.
I know. That'd be nice. But I hate the sound of no sound at all, too.
Oh, my God.
I'm choosing. I have to have some type of noise.
Okay. But it can't be moist, chewy, clacky noise. Yeah. Oh, perfect. You could put some salsa music on while you do your math.
Do my
tests.
Math? Perfect.
So tell them you need that.
That'd be everything. That'd be amazing.
Yeah. I think schools can accommodate your needs.
I think they should. I think they could.
Yeah. And so... You're not going to go into musical performance. Let's pretend. What other profession would you like to try?
Maybe something like completely opposite from what I feel like I'm good at, like tech type of computer science type stuff, maybe. I feel like that could be interesting.
I'm going to warn you, some of those keyboards are really loud.
Oh, no, I just thought about
like
that.
Like really clacky. We just got a new one. It's
goodness.
Sensory overload.
Oh, God.
So, I mean, I'm not saying you made a terrible choice of your second choice profession, but...
I have to rethink that one.
Yeah, but you could turn the salsa music up really loud in your office. So, maybe it'll work out.
It always comes back to salsa. That'll always save me. Salsa music will always save me.
We'll save you from all the chewers and clackers in the world. What profession would you not like to try?
Probably being an athlete.
Oh.
I don't like the idea of having to keep my body in shape all the time.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
And maybe that's not how athletics work, but I feel like they're always in shape.
I got to tell you, I'm not certain how athletics work. Would not be the person to ask.
I do not do sports, but...
yeah, I think if your body is like built to be really good at running, then, you know, go for
it'd be
it.
Easy, right?
Run. But there's no reason to try if you're just Like, I have really long legs, but I can't run neither, at all.
Yeah, I know. Same, but I...
No coordination.
My body's not for running. It's not.
No, I don't
I get it.
Hey. Good. I like that. That answer is really... That's like, know thyself. And so you're at Bedford Farms, and everybody's chewing very quietly. What kind of ice cream would you get?
I'm getting sweet cream.
Really? Sweet cream. Sweet cream.
And I know everyone says it's plain...
It's got no chunks in it.
But
nothing.
I like I'm a fan of vanilla and just like creamy, just like plain ice cream. Like
and
I don't
then
like
you put
too
like
much.
Sprinkles and hot fudge and marshmallows.
No.
Wow.
The only thing I put on my ice cream like currently is like I'll put cinnamon in it. I love cinnamon in my ice cream. Love it.
I would never have guessed that.
I love it. And then I like whipped cream too.
Do you like cardamom? Like, have you ever had a chai tea?
Yeah. Is that what that's about?
Yeah, right?
I love
right,
chai.
Paula, off screen, off camera? She doesn't know. yeah, I bet you would like cardamom.
No, I love chai, so I'm sure I probably would.
Yeah, that's definitely in that same spice family. Do you like nutmeg?
Love nutmeg. I love the spices.
So you like the fall, if I had to pick.
Oh, I was born in the fall. It's my season. November 26th. I was born on Thanksgiving.
Were you really? Mm-hmm. The year you were born, it was Thanksgiving.
Yep, November 26th, it was Thanksgiving.
Oh, so how many Thanksgiving birthdays have you had? That is not on the card.
My last birthday?
Yeah.
I feel like it was last year. No, was it this? Was it last
year?
It
was recent, though?
It was either last year or the year before that my birthday was on Thanksgiving.
Wow.
It
and
was
do you
recent.
Like pie?
I love pie. I love pie. I prefer pie over cake.
Yeah, so that's like
the big debate.
Major win on
exactly.
your birthday. Like pecan pie.
I love pecan pie. I love
pumpkin
sweet potato pie.
Ooh,
pumpkin
sweet
pie.
Potato pie.
Love it all.
One year my mother made an apple pie, a pecan pie, a squash pie, and a pumpkin pie.
Wow.
I was in heaven.
That sounds like heaven.
I know.
That sounds amazing. I've never had a squash pie.
It was very similar to the pumpkin pie. Don't tell my mother. But so sweet potato pie, how is that different from pumpkin pie?
So sweet potato pie is sweet potatoes.
Right.
Pumpkin
right.
pie.
This is the part of the show where we explain the obvious to Tom.
I think.
The flavor profile, Natalie.
I mean.
Just think back to eating it. All right. I shouldn't go off topic.
No, I'm trying to figure out the difference between like pumpkin taste and sweet potato taste. It's just.
No, they're different.
Pumpkin-y is kind of, right. I guess it's more savory, I would say, in my opinion. And then the sweet potato is just going to be sweet.
Mm-hmm.
It's like all sweet.
Mm-hmm. Do you ever have the sweet potatoes with the marshmallows on
I don't
top?
Think I've ever had that, no.
Oh my gosh.
Is that good? I've never had that.
I think you might like it. You take like some sort of sweet potato mush. I'm sure there's a recipe. Mm-hmm. And then you put marshmallows on top and you like broil the marshmallows.
Wow.
Do you like
marshmallows? I love
like
marshmallows.
Toasted marshmallows?
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe
good.
Add that to Thanksgiving 2016.
Yeah, my whole family's from the South, so maybe we don't do that in the South. Maybe it's a Northern thing.
Maybe.
It's a Northern tradition.
Maybe. Southern Thanksgiving. Yum.
Amazing.
Wow. We should just
amazing.
Do a whole show about food.
Please. And then we can have sweet potatoes on sweet potato pie and pumpkin pie. We'll figure it out.
We could have samples distributed to all the viewers ahead of time. Let's say, like, do not open until November 3rd or something. I'm just picking
Perfect.
A random date in the fall. It would have to
Love
be
it.
In the fall. Yeah. Good. Well, I'm glad you're here for another year. That we're not,
I'm excited.
You're still in because we got a lot of plans now.
We do.
We need to have this fall. If you were going to college, I don't know what I'd do. I'd have to be, like, a weird stalker.
I know. We have time.
Okay. All right. So I let's pretend I have a phone. I don't.
Okay.
And it can call anyone in the world, living, dead, made up.
Oh, gosh.
Do you know who you'd call, or do you need a minute?
Off the top of my head, probably just Michael Jackson.
Oh,
he's Michael? The first one that comes to mind.
Would you ask him to explain some of his odd, more confusing later life actions, or would you want like early Michael Jackson?
I want the most recent Michael Jackson I can get.
Really?
Yes, because I need to know how he. First of all, he was. I feel like. His personal life aside, his craziness aside, he was talented like all throughout his career. Like I can't think of a time where Michael Jackson did make good music, in my opinion.
Yes, that's accurate.
So like I want to ask him, first of all, how he did that.
Yeah.
Because I feel like a lot of musicians currently end up going downhill as they get older.
Not mentioning any names.
No. or they'll have like a downhill and then have like an uphill. And I just feel like he's been consistently good.
That was pretty remarkable.
As a musician.
Yeah.
Like in his personal life, maybe I won't even ask about it. I don't want
to know. No, there won't be enough time.
I don't
want
to know. Exactly.
It's like a 5-minute phone call.
Exactly.
So you gotta stick with what's important. That's a good choice.
I'd probably thank him too, just for.
I would be so distracted by his personal life that I'm glad you approached it from a more professional perspective.
Gotta get the stuff I need first, then.
And did you say you'd thank him? That's so nice.
I'd have to thank him.
Yeah.
For all that he has given us musically. Yeah.
He really did influence multiple generations.
Yep. And he still does today. It's amazing.
Yeah.
Always.
I have to have a moment of silence for Michael Jackson.
I know, just
at our sweet potato. Oh, want to have it now?
Okay. No. Whenever you're ready. I was prepared to do it now, but whenever you think it's okay, we'll do it then.
Yeah, I mean, we can do it now and at our pie eating day.
Great.
Whatever.
Great.
I have like 1,000 more questions to ask you, but I don't think any more have to do with Bedford Backstage.
Okay, whatever.
So, I do want to hear more about your Southern Thanksgiving menu. Were you born in the South?
I was born in Tallahassee.
Oh, in Tallahassee. Mm-hmm. So how many places have you lived?
So, I was born in Florida.
Sure.
And then we moved to Alabama.
Okay.
Then North Carolina.
Okay.
Then California.
That's a little bit of a detour.
That's a far. That's a big one.
Because you said your father was in the Coast Guard.
Mm-hmm. So we moved a lot of places, yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. And then from California?
Maryland.
To Maryland.
And then here.
And what's been your favorite place to live so far?
Well, I lived in Maryland the longest. I lived there for 5 years. So I'd have to say that one's my favorite because that's the one where I made most of my memories,
right,
I would say.
Right.
So, yeah. Wow. That's probably my favorite.
Do you still keep in touch with your friends from Maryland?
Oh, yeah. I go back there many times. I'm going back like the day after school ends, like June 18th, I'm flying back.
I think school ends on the 20th.
No, that's the makeup exam day. So hopefully I won't have to make up exams. That's the makeup exam day. So hopefully I won't even need to be there. And if it was
so
a day,
lucky.
I'd have to miss it.
Wow.
Yeah.
So you can go on the 18th. I was a little worried for a second there.
No, so was my mom. Everyone was kind of worried. And I was like, if the 20th is a school day, I'm just going to miss it because I have to go back.
You already have the tickets.
Exactly. And I figured, I even calculated that we were going to end there. That was going to be our makeup day and that I'd be okay. But
that'll be fun.
I know. I'm really excited.
Wow.
I'm really excited.
Oh, have fun.
Yeah.
Well, to all of our viewers out there, thank you so much for tuning into this informative, entertaining episode of Bedford Backstage. We're glad you could join us.